Hi, Kristie Carter with the new Slow Video Magazine, and I am here at TruHealth Chiropractic with David, the owner, and he's a local entrepreneur in San Luis Obispo. And I wanted to hear a little bit about what he does and what he gives back to the community and how he runs a business in Slow, local Cal Poly graduate. So, hi, David.
You're probably wondering what upper cervical chiropractic is, and a lot of people have never heard of it, but upper cervical is a specific application of chiropractic to the very top of the neck, the vertebra that's called the atlas, and the one below that's called the axis, and then also the base of the skull, which is called the occiput. And the three of those bones, they form a very dynamic set of like a biomechanical system that not only balances the weight of our head, but also protects our brainstem as it comes through the base of the skull. Unlike the rest of the spine, the upper cervical spine, there's no disc up there. So you've heard of like a bulging disc, you've heard of a herniated disc, or you've heard of sciatica, which is basically a disc impinging on one of your lumbar nerves there. Those discs are essentially like rubbery gaskets that glue the spine together. But up in the upper neck area, there's no disc. It's basically a free-floating system.
So what can throw off the upper cervical?
What can cause an upper cervical subluxation? You would know by the first thing that you would notice is your posture. Mm-hmm. So the atlas is actually a very small ring-shaped bone. It's about this big here, and it's like a little ring, and it's balancing the weight of your skull. And if it goes just out of alignment, even just a little bit, the weight of the head will kind of fall to one side. Maybe you can look at pictures of yourself from the past and notice that your head is always tilting to one side, the same side, every picture. Because of that, your brain will tell the rest of your spine to contort in a way to balance the weight of your head. So you see maybe one of your shoulders go up. Or you may notice that like one of your legs appears shorter than the other. It just feels like you're walking all. Well, that's really an adaptive response to your atlas not being properly centered under your skull. And that's the first thing that you notice. Another thing is just living day to day in this adaptive posture, you start to get back pain. You start to like, if you're lifting, if you're just in this adaptive posture, you're lifting something, you're doing heavy, even working out, all twisted, eventually your joints are gonna wear unevenly. And your muscles aren't gonna be working symmetrically, if you will. And then lo and behold, you may get a lot of aches and pains up down your back. And you may say, hey, you know, my low back really hurts. Why are you adjusting my upper neck? What does that have to do? Well, that's why, is because we need to get your head back over your body, and then your own brain will start to unwind the rest of your spine, right? The last kind of manifestation of an upper cervical subluxation, what we call, is things like headaches or TMJ or fatigue or all kinds of weird things that are neurological in nature, as a result of your body basically exerting a lot of effort in order to maintain your head straight. It's basically you only have a certain amount of energy to do work in your body. And if your body is basically diverting a lot of that energy to stabilizing your head, then it'll start to neglect other systems. This is a holistic approach to healthcare. And just to distinguish the difference between those two things, in allopathic, you know, every disease, every condition that you have, there's a specific treatment for it. There's a certain drug or a certain surgery, a certain therapy that you do for that disease. But in holistic healthcare, the holistic doctor really tries to figure out where there is a deficiency or a toxicity. And that's the only thing, the only reason why anyone would ever get sick is as a result of just those two things. In this case, it's a deficiency, and the deficiency is in the normal motion of the spine. A lot of people don't know that the joints in the spine, actually every joint in your body, has what are called proprioceptors or mechanoreceptors, and they feed your brain with information about what's going on in that joint. The only way to send a signal to your brain from a joint is to actually move that joint. If a joint is not moving, then that signal doesn't get propagated to your brain. Now, there's a certain density of these proprioceptors per volume of joint space, and they increase as we go up to the neck here. And so the spine has a really high density of these proprioceptors in those joints. The knuckles, not so much. But in these joints up here in the upper neck, they're like hundreds and hundreds of times more than anywhere else in your whole body. And so if you have a subluxation, a misalignment in the upper neck, and those joints aren't moving normally, then you can think of that as being a really big territory of your brain that's not getting the information that it needs. And in that way, there's a deficiency in the normal proprioception. And so by getting your spine corrected and your biomechanics restored, then over time, your brain starts to receive that input and, you know, you start to feel healthier, basically supplying a deficiency in that. How much loss of disc space do they have? How many bone spurs and how far off they are to begin with? Now, I've seen people with really crummy spines, especially when we look at them on the x-rays, all kinds of bone spurs everywhere. And it's pretty amazing how in just a couple of visits, they start to feel a lot better. You know, it's not gonna reverse any of those changes, but at the end of the day, they feel better and they are able to move better. One thing that I hear a lot is like, I used to drive and I used to have to turn my whole body to look, to change lanes. And for some reason, I can actually turn my head to look behind me without, and that's kind of a cool thing. If you can help somebody do that, is pretty awesome. But to answer your question more specifically, I do things in 6-visit increments. So, and there's different phases of care that we do here. So we do a stabilization phase. Stabilization is basically restoring the biomechanics of the upper cervical spine specifically. Right, and we're just focusing on that. So we do 6 visits of that. And then we move into, sometimes people have extremity problems. So a shoulder or a knee or a hip or something like that. And so we do a phase called what I call a transformation. So not only are we looking at the upper cervical spine, but we'll do treatments to those specific joints because we want to restore biomechanics to the whole body. That's my whole goal. It's like, I want every joint in the person's body to be functioning. Yeah.